How to set BACnet communication in ATV 212. Hello, I will guide you through a quick commissioning of BACnet communication on an ATV 212. Here is the ATV 212 equipped with a terminal card. This card has two communication ports. The RJ45 port is used only for Modbus communication, SOMOVE connection, for example. The OpenStyle port is used for many other protocols. Use the SOMOVE cable to connect the computer to the ATV212. Now, connect SOMOVE to the ATV212 for BACnet setting. Go to the Parameters view. Then go to the ATV212 Communication menu. The first parameter to set is Communication Channel Choice. This parameter can be set to RJ45 or OpenStyle. To control the ATV212 through BACnet, set it to F807=1. Then go to the Network Protocol parameter and set it to 4 to activate BACnet protocol. To set the BACnet address of ATV212, go to the next parameter, F890. This one can have a value from 1 to 127. In this example, it will be set to F890=8. Be careful, you should not have two devices with the same BACnet address on the same network. Set the BACnet communication speed in the parameter Network Baud Rate. The possible values for this parameter are 1 for 9600 bits per second, 2 for 19200 bits per second, 3 for 38400 bits per second, 4 for 76800 bits per second, and 5 for auto. In auto, the drive attempts to detect the network baud rate. For this example, the last value is chosen, but if you know the BACnet PLC speed, it's better to choose the corresponding value of F891. Then, set the timeout in the parameter Network Timeout. When the communication is lost between the ATV212 and BACnet controller, the ATV212 waits for the expiration of this timeout before trip-in error. The value of F892 is adjustable anywhere between 2.0 seconds and 60.0 seconds. The parameters F893 and F894 are used to set the instance number. The instance number is unique on the entire BACnet network. No other device anywhere on the network may have the same BACnet instance number. The parameter F894 represents the last 3 digits of the instance number. The parameter F893 represents the first 4 digits. For example, if the instance number is set to 0235045, the F894 parameter should be set to 45, and the F893 should be set to 235. On the parameter F895 called Max Master, a value equal to or greater than the highest BACnet address present in the bus should be set. In this example, the highest BACnet address in this network is 9. So on ATV212, you can set the parameter to F895=9. On the parameter F896, set the max info frames. This parameter specifies how many messages the ATV212 can send to the BACnet controllers when it has the token on the network. On factory setting, the value of this parameter on ATV212 is 1. In this example, F896 is set to 2, This means that if the ATV212 receives the token on the BACnet network and has four objects whose values have changed, it will send the new values of the first and second objects, and wait until the next time it gets the token to send the third and fourth object's new value. The value of F896 is adjustable between 0 and 100. To very quickly update the ATV212 object, increase the value of this parameter. Be aware that setting a higher value in this parameter can impact the update of other BACnet devices. The parameter F851 allows you to set the ATV212 behavior after a communication interruption. In factory settings, F851 equals 4. This means that after a BACnet cable disconnection and expiration of the BACnet timeout, the ATV212 will trip an error 8. The table shows the other possible values for F851. To control the ATV212 fully by BACnet, go to the Programming menu. Set frequency mode selection to 4 Serial Com Ref. This allows you to send the reference via BACnet. Then, on the parameter Command Mode Selection, choose 2 Communication to enable the control via BACnet. Now disconnect SOMOVE. Power off the drive and connect the BACnet cable. Pay attention to BACnet signals. Now, power on the ATV212. Check the master BACnet setting. Using the master interface, you can discover the ATV212 and its objects. Here, we set the PLC BACnet parameter. And this is the address of PLC. These are the different objects supported by ATV212. If you want to monitor current, set the polling time to check the current value. Motor voltage, DC bus voltage. This is the monitoring area. You can add the registers you want to check. Use the object binary value number 10, named run stop command, to run and stop the drive. Set 1 to run the drive, then set 0 on this object to stop the drive. Use the object analog value number 16, named input ref1, to send the reference. 100% correspond to upper limit frequency UL. In this example, UL equals 50.0 Hz. We set input ref1 to 50%. The motor will turn at 25.0 Hz. Then we set this object to 100%. The motor will run at 50.0 Hz. Go to Run Stop command and set it to 0 to stop the drive. You can see the output frequency is now 0. The drive is stopped. Need help with SoMove? Press F1 on any given item to open the contextual help or the product programming manual. Thank you for watching. For more information, please visit our website.